الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All thanks and praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek refuge with Allah from our bad deed and our bad action. The one whom Allah guide, no one will misguide. The one who's misguided, no one will guide. I bear witness, there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Fardu al-Samad, al-Wahid al-Ahad. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his messenger and slave. Indeed, the best of the speech is the speech of the Quran. The best of the guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The worst of the matters in our religion is the innovation. Each innovation can be a misguide, and each misguide can lead us to the hellfire, wa ya'adhu billah. Allahumma laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azim sultanika hamdan yamla as-samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. Allahumma laka alhamdu anta qayyumu as-samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. Allahumma laka alhamdu anta maliku as-samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. Allahumma laka alhamdu anta rabbu as-samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that we have. Allahumma laka alhamdu ala ni'mati al-islami wa kafa biha ni'ma. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ni'mah of the Islam. An Suhayb ibn Sinan fi sahih Muslim qal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ajaban li amri al-mu'min fa inna amrahu kullahu lahu khayr فإن أصابته سراء شكر فكان خيرا له وإن أصابته ضراء صبر فكان خيرا له. In Sahih Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, strange the condition of the believer. And this is only for the believer. If a good thing happened to them, they say, Alhamdulillah. And this is good for them. When a bad thing happened to them, they have patience. And this is also good for them. So it's a definition here of a believer and how he counter challenge. Or what we perceive is bad. Because what's come from Allah, alhamdulillah, is good. But we might think it's bad for you. And then you discover later on is bad. So good, bad, we say alhamdulillah and we have patience. وَجَاءَ فِي التِّرْمِذِي وَابْنُ مَاجَةَ وَأَحْمَدْ عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصة وتروح بطانة. Another hadith, authentic hadith, says if you depend on Allah the way it deserves, as he will provide for you as he provide for the bird. In the morning, the bird leave his nest with empty stomach and come back later with full stomach for trust on Allah Azza wa Jalla. وقال الحق سبحانه وتعالى ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه. The one who's gonna depend, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, the one who's gonna depend on Allah, Allah will be sufficient for him. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And the one who's going to depend on Allah, Allah will find an outlet for them and will provide for them from the way they don't even recognize. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. And depend on the one who never died. These are one of the ayat that's very dear to my heart. And maybe too many times I explain it, I transfer it, maybe you guys memorize it by now. But it's good to repeat so it can stick in our heart and our mind. Allah didn't say just tawakkal ala al-hayy. But he said tawakkal ala al-hayy alladhi la yamut. Allah didn't say just depend on the one who's alive. فَصِفَةِ الْحَيَاةِ قَدْ يَشْتَرِكْ فِيهَا الْبَشَرُ وَاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَاللَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Sifa, when we say somebody he's alive, you're alive, I'm alive, a king is alive, a rich man is alive. So if somebody comes and tell you, don't worry about it, I'm going to take care of you for the rest of your life, right? I'm going to deposit in your bank account every month $10,000. You don't have to be worried about it. So you're very excited. You go to sleep, you think about this person. What about if something happened to that person? What about if he got sick? Rather, what happened if he got upset with me? Now you cannot sleep. You're too much worried. That's why Allah says in the Quran, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. Then depend on the one who's alive. Never die. Because this thought, it will never gonna come in your mind. That Allah will let you go. Allah will provide for you. As a matter of fact, He did it 50,000 years before you were created. And that should just give you peace of mind and relaxation day in and day out. Most of us worry. We wake up worried. We go to sleep worried. What is going to happen to my kids? What is going to happen to my business? What if this happened? Some got tested with their health. Some got tested with their financial. Some got tested with their family. Whatever the case may be. Us as a believer, as a mu'mineen, we must depend on Allah Azza wa Jal. We must, in the bottom of our heart, we know whatever is coming in my way is not going to miss me. Whatever is going to miss me is not going to come in my way. If there is something coming for me to eat, nobody will eat it. If there is coming to me in my way, if there is a knowledge I'm trying to seek, if there is a position I'm looking to have, it will come. It will come if you have the full i'timad ma'a al-akhd bil-asbab, with taking the means, which we'll go into it a little bit, but full tawakkul Allah. This is the beginning. To start with full tawakkul Allah Azza wa Jal. Full tawakkul. And Ibn Hatim al-Asam gave us an example in that. As it came in the book with the stories that Hatim Sam want to go to Hajj, and then his daughter and her family rather complain and say, we don't have money if you leave us. And everybody was complaining. So he's debating, should I go to Hajj or not? So the daughter says, Allah is the one who gives us rizq. So whether you stay with us or not, whatever is coming is coming. Just go on and Allah will provide for us. Indeed, he went to Hajj. And then they sitting and her mother, her sister complaining, you make him go to Hajj and now we have nothing, right? Worry what's coming tomorrow. We get ourselves in a system that we are all worried about what's gonna happen tomorrow. SubhanAllah. So anyway, so whether the Amir or the Khalifa at the time, he's passing by the town, got so thirsty, asked for a water. He was in the front of his house. They brought him the water. The water was too nice, cold, got comfortable. He said, where does this water come from? It came from the house of Had. Should have Rajul Salih, the righteous man. They said, yes. He said, brought him to me so I can thank him for it. They said, no, he went to Hajj. And he said, he left his family. He said, yeah. So he said, must on me, haqqun alay. And he put his pocket in his hand in his pocket, and took a little, bag of gold. That's how when Muslim was in control, they used to deal with real money, not paper, right? We have gold and dinar and dirham. That's what the real worth, not something that's not backed up, right? That's the beauty of being, under the ruling of Islam. People can really have wealth. They can accommodate wealth, right? This is just one of the little slight benefit when Islam ruled. So he said, حَقٌ عَلَيْ, indeed, it's a must that to share this fund with them. And then he looks at the people around him and said, if somebody loves me, we'll do the same. So everybody starts to drop what they have in their pocket. So now the family is very excited and happy. So the daughter starts to cry. So what's the story with you? Now we are rich, She said, just because a slave of Allah looked at us, make us rich. What about if Allah Azza wa Jal look at us and taking care of us? The daughter knows Allah, mashallah. When she was asked, how you have full confidence in Allah, how you have this trust, tawakkul on Allah Azza wa Jal all the time. She said, "Da'alimtu anna rizqi lan ya'khudhu ghayri, fatma'anna qalbi." She said, "I knew in the bottom of my heart that my risk, my sense, whatever Allah will bring to me, it's coming to me. Nobody will take it. So what should I be worried about? وَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّ عَمَلِي لَنْ يُتْقِنْهُ غَيْرِ فَانْشَغَلْتُ بِهِ. And I know that my business, whatever I do, I'm good at it. I'm going to do my best at it, and I'm going to be worried about it. Just said, do what you have to do, and Allah will provide for you. وَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَانِ فَخَشِيتَ نَعْصَانِ. And I know that Allah is watching me all the time. So I'm worried that I'm going to disobey Allah Azza wa Jalla. وعلمت أن اللقاء قادم. And I know the meeting is coming. Meeting with who? With your boss? With the president? Meeting with Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْعَلَى. She said, I knew this meeting is coming. And this meeting is coming. No way to run away from it. Smart one, the one who's preparing for that meeting. She said, I know the meeting is coming, so I have to prepare for it. When you have this combination of way of thinking, you're not going to be worried too much about, oh my God, I lost this transaction. Oh my God, I was supposed to make this money. Oh, I missed my flight. I did this. I won this. It's okay. قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ مَا شَاءَ فَعَلَ. You don't know what hold you from that. It could be worse maybe if you would have got that. أنت هلا سمعت إلى كلمات الله. Have you heard in the Quran that some, they wish to have a lot of money. They said, oh Allah, if you bring me money, I will spend it. In the sake of, I'm just going to spend it. And as soon as they get the money, what happened? They don't even want to pay the zakat. So it's good, the money to come to them is a good thing or a bad thing? Bad thing, of course. In this dunya and the hereafter. What he was wishing for, he got. But indeed, he didn't get benefit from it. So don't be sorry for something related to the dunya. لا تحزن على ما فاتك في الدنيا. Don't be worried about something you missed yesterday in the dunya. Rather, what you should be worried about something that you missed yesterday to get you closer to Allah. So if you miss a prayer yesterday, yeah, be sad about it. Be very sad about it. If you miss something to get you closer to Allah, be sad about it. Because that's what the real deal to get. If you worry about your kids tomorrow, don't be worried about it. Because Allah created you and created your kids with their income. With everything is gonna happen. So why too much worry about it? And again, don't take my word as we fully depend on Allah and we leave the mean. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give us the example that depend on Allah and take the means. Tawakkul Allah ma'al akhd bil asbab. In the time when he was leaving Mecca, right? And he was the most wanted, right? They want him life, dead at the time. And Abu Bakr was with him. What did he do? He didn't say, I'm the Prophet. I depend on Allah. Allah will do everything for me. He didn't just do that. He took the means, right? Instead of going north, he went south. He called somebody to make sure the road is ready for them. He hired somebody to go after them so they you know, erase, you know, the footsteps so nobody can follow them. He did all the means. He did what he had to do with tawakkul Allah Azza wa Jal, with full tawakkul. على الله عز وجل. He put his trust on Allah عز وجل. And this make us feel comfortable. Make us every day go to sleep comfortable. Wake up in the morning comfortable. Even though if you have somebody who's actually threatening you, or somebody make you believe, oh, you are Muslim right now and there is a lot of situation, take your hijab off. Oh, don't look like a Muslim. Don't do this, don't do that. That's the situation that most of the Muslim in. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فخشوا فزادهم إيمان وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. This is the mindset for the believer. This is what the Sahaba taught us when they practiced these ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at the situation of the people. When they came to the Sahaba and they said, hey, be careful. The people gather for you. People, they doing so many things to harm you. And that's what you hear left and right always in the news. Careful, this and this and that. Scare the people of Muslim and everything also. Put in your heart and your mind. And if you're weak enough, you don't have this trust and tawakkul Allah, what are you going to do? You're probably going to change your name from Muhammad to Mo, right? and you're going to pretend that you got nothing to do with Islam. We see it. We live with it. Right? But when you hear this ayah, you'll put your trust more on Allah Azza wa Jal. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمْ النَّاسَ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. Be careful. Be aware of these people, they're going to harm. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَان. Actually, their iman increased. Their iman, not fear now. No, I'm increased because I have Allah by my side. So now their iman increased. And what did they say? حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah is sufficient for us. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. As Ibn Abbas said, قَالَهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ عَنْدَمَا رَمُوهُ فِي النَّارِ وَقَالَ مُحَمَّدُ وَأَصْحَابُهُ. Ibrahim said when they wanted to throw him in the fire, he said, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. How many of us remember these things when any just worry or something comes and say, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah is sufficient for us. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. So this is the mindset. This is the situation. I can face this every day in my business. Anybody can face that in their life, that any news can come to you. It happens to me last week, I got a full inspection from my office, right? And that's very difficult because they go through all the accounts and everything, right? So, alhamdulillah, we don't do anything wrong, but just the fact is like somebody's just looking and you have to prepare everything. When I went home that night, I was like, worry, it's nature, right? You're gonna be worried and you know, whatever. And then I got a call from this lady and she said, well, they give me your number and I need help because my husband was killed and my daughter have a heart attack. I said, man, I'm in a much better shape. I'll just get somebody to inspect my office. And somebody in a much, much worse situation, right? So you always say, alhamdulillah, for what you have. Because when you look at other people, issues, much, much deeper than what you have. But when you put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jal, then you'll feel the comfort. You're gonna feel, alhamdulillah, I'm good. What a mentality when you live with it. As a mu'min, it's only for the believer. That's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. Only for the believer. When something good happened, you say alhamdulillah. When something bad happened, you say alhamdulillah. And you're patient about it. Don't be like what Allah says. مِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفِ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ ذَلِكَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. أعوذ بالله. Just listen to the ayah. Understand. It said, don't be like the people that when something good happened to them, now they are very excited. We are going to this category. Anything happened good, we're very excited, we're very happy about it. What about when something bad happened? When something happened bad, why me? Why Allah chose me to do it? Why not somebody else? I am Muslim. I pray. I do this. I give the care. So why Allah? Because the lack of understanding your aqeedah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the most tested is the anbiya, because of the level of the iman. And then after that, salihin, and the one who gets closer to Allah, they're going to be more tested. Tested in any way and shape you can think of. Might have a family member who's sick. You might have a daughter, like this lady when she called me, she said her daughter young and she have a heart, you know, issues, and she has to worry about it. She cannot leave work, or she go to work to take in care of her. Her husband was killed. It's just, you know, subhanAllah, you think about these things, but because you put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jal, that you'll be in ease, in ease. And Ibn Abbas called, and we all know this hadith, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam take the shoulder of Ibn Abbas, he said, Ya ghulam, u'allimuka kalimat. Oh, little boy or ghulam, son, I will teach you some words. احفظ الله يحفظك واحفظ الله تجده تجاهك وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله وإذا سألت فاسأل الله واعلم إن اجتمعت الأمة على أن ينفعوك بشيء لن ينفعوك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله عليك الله عليك وإذا اجتمعت الأمة على أن يضروك بشيء لن يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله عليك. If you wanna put the end of the hadith to practice, because everybody hear the hadith, they come to the end of it, said, great. This is very confident. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, I'll bring you the end of it. No, for sure. If this whole, everybody in the face of the earth, that's what the hadith says. If everybody gather together and say, we're gonna meet tonight because we wanna plan how we're gonna harm you tomorrow. Everybody in the face of the earth. Just imagine that. and Allah didn't write it down, nothing is going to happen to you. Nothing is going to harm you. And if everybody gathered to benefit you, to come tomorrow and get your wish dream to come true, that's not going to happen unless if Allah wants it to happen. So now the Muslim got very excited. Then you must practice the beginning of the hadith. Then to reach this, you must practice the beginning of the hadith. احفظ الله يحفظك. So when you protect the orders of Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah will protect you. When you know what's the haram and what's the halal, and you stay away from it. When you know prayers, it's mawaqeen. There is time for it. And this is the obligation for Allah Azza wa Jal before anybody else. So it doesn't matter what situation I have, I'm arranging my day according to this prayer. And on and on and on. What's my right for my wife? What's my wife's right for me? What's my right for my kids? What's my right for my neighbors, Muslim or not Muslim? حقوق. Rights. فَإِحْفَظِ اللَّهَ يَحْفَظِكَ إِحْفَظِ اللَّهَ تَجِدُ دُجَاكَ. You're going to know He's by your side, Azza wa Jal. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتْ فَسَأَلِ اللَّهَ. Hadith, بَادِ بِالْعَقِيدَةِ. If you want to ask, ask only Allah. I was just listening with my son in the car. I got a message. I guess one with the church. If I've been getting this message, I don't know how I can delete it, but it goes like, if you want us to make prayer for you today, call us. I don't know if it's going to come to a payment or something later on, but if you want to do a prayer for us, whatever. So I'm listening to the message with my son. I said, what is this? You know? There's nobody between us and Allah Azza wa Jal. You know what's, how close are you to Allah Azza wa Jal? When you make sujood. You are close, كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. You just make sujood to Allah Azza wa Jal and make dua with what you want from Allah Azza wa Jal. And again, if it's good, Allah will make it happen for you. If it's not good for you, Allah will make it get away from you. So don't be sad when your dua is not being accepted, because Allah knows best. Allah have hikmah that we don't know about it. So this is what what's in. So احفظ الله يحفظ احفظ الله تجده وإذا سألت فاسأل الله. If you want to ask, ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Don't ask anybody else. This is aqeedah. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعَنْ بِاللَّهِ. And you want to put your trust and your tawakkul. And what you want is only from Allah. Only for Allah. A lot of us falls in most of the... Alhamdulillah, we don't see it here. Hopefully, we're not going to see it soon. But most of a lot of Muslim country, what they have? They have graves inside masajid. That they said this person was a good, righteous person, close to Allah. So what they want to do? They want to go and maybe bring food. And bring whatever. People deceiving. Jah. You don't know about aqeedah. The basic thing. As one of my visit to my home, I went to pray Jummah. So I just need any masjid close by me. So I went, and mashallah, it was a huge masjid. I mean, I couldn't even see the imam. It was mashallah, the member was too high, and I was like, okay, mashallah. Guy coming from school, he's wearing this little thing. I said, mashallah, great. Listen to the khutbah, I'm leaving. I see people walking from the sideboard with all fruits and everything. I said, what is it, lunch? What's going on? So I looked and I see a grave. And I said, what's the name of this mosque? I said, Sidi Bishr. This is the name of the masjid. And what does that mean? Sidi is like my mawla or whatever, Allah, my somebody, and that's his name, right? I was like, oh my God. I was praying in a place like that, So this is indeed, this is where the stand of a stand is. If you want to put your trust, you put it on Allah Azza wa Jal. Nobody can come and tell you this. I'm going to get you closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. Yeah, I can make dua for my brother. And we can make dua for each other, right? But nothing between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. Then when you have this combination in the beginning of the hadith, then you're going to know for fact. No matter what's going to happen, you're not going to get harmed. Whatever Allah wrote it for you. Maybe whatever's happening to you, get you closer. How many people get sick? And that was the reason for them to get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. They were too far away from the deen. And when they get sick, they get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. So not necessarily whatever is happening to you, you think it's harmful, but indeed, it's something good to you. قُلُوا قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. I think this story was mentioned in the book of forget the name of the book, but anyway, the story goes like this: this king, he had one of his helper, right? Anna. I don't remember that book of the name. Anyway, so he have a helper next to him. He's a king, right? And this helper, everything the king do, he goes what? He say, Al-khira fi makhtar Allah. The good in what Allah choose for us. So one day this king was sitting down and he was cutting the fruit, and then he ended up cutting his hand. What comes out of his hand? So this helper goes, Al-khira fi makhtar Allah. The good in what Allah choose for us. So he got very upset. And he said, like, you see me cutting myself and the blood coming out, and you say, Al-khir, what's good in this? Right? Take him to jail. So they took him to jail. So he's walking to jail and he said, Al-khira fi makhtar Allah. The good in what Allah choose for us. Right? Again, how many people, they became Muslim in jail? MashaAllah, there was a documentary. As a matter of fact, they tell you, MashaAllah, they cannot stop it in jail. People coming Muslim. Why? Because they have time to read and educate themselves. So when they do, they find out the truth. And that's it. As simple as that. But unfortunately, outside the jail, we got busy too much and too many things. Us as a Muslim, we don't know our religion because we're too busy with so many things. You have the disaster, the TV in your house, right? You have all the devices. You're just too busy. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to go and reflect. He used to go to the mountain, just sit down and reflect of the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. How many times we just left our home, went in the backyard and look at the sky. And we say, Subhanallah. We say, Subhanallah, the creation of Allah. Reflection. So anyway, so he said, what? Al-khira fi makhtar Allah. This king used to like to hunt. So he goes hunting. And he got lost between, you know, obviously whatever they were hunting in. And then he went to a tribe, and this tribe, they worship in the fire, whatever, and their tradition is to sacrifice people for the fire. I guess they're still doing it now, in some places, you know. That's why we need Islam. That's why we need Islam, to rule the people. You can't imagine, there's certain places on the face of the earth right now, they sacrifice people for their worship. Recently, Hindus went to eat in a restaurant, I think was in the Middle East, and they discover after they eat that they ate meat, cow. So they were crying, running around, it was a video, and they were saying, oh, our God is in our stomach. And they went inside the kitchen and they destroyed the whole kitchen. Educated people, but they missed what they were created for. So anyway, this king goes and he starts to hunt, he got lost, these people capture him, they put him in a table ready to sacrifice him. And all of a sudden they see the cut in his hand. And subhanAllah, even though people, you know, in the wrong path, they know when we want to sacrifice something, it has to be good. No deficiency on the sacrifice, right? That's what we do to Alhamdulillah. Allah will love you and His Messenger when you give what you like. So when you hear somebody needs something and you have clothes in your closet, don't think, let me get rid of the cut clothes. Let me get rid of the old clothes. This is a test. If you get rid of your new clothes, that means you love to give from what you have best. You're not going to become a true believer, good to Allah, until you spend from what you love. Until you spend from what you love. So anyway, they said, this guy has a problem, we cannot sacrifice him, let him go. Now he's happy going back, and he remembered what his helper said. Al-khira fi makhtar Allah. So he started to realize, wow, that's really, this cut was a reason for me to be safe, not to be killed, get him out of jail. So he bring him out, said, hey, I really now try to understand your statement, but I'm just confused. When you were going to jail, you said, ya al-khira fi makhtar Allah, that wouldn't what Allah choose. So what's, you know, what's in it? He said, because most likely, if I wouldn't go to jail, I wouldn't be with you on this trip. And they would have taken me instead of you, right? And then I would be killed. So alhamdulillah, khira fi makhtar Allah, that he was in jail, he wasn't with this king. Otherwise, he would be taken too as well, right? Musa, the mother of Musa, she knew that whatever she depend on Allah Azza wa Jal, the good is what's gonna come. So putting her son in the war, right? In the Nile, that's what Allah, she put her trust in Allah. And indeed, that was the one who was raised and saved in the house in Fir'aun. When Musa alayhi salam leaving and Fir'aun and his army behind him and the water in front of him, Allah told him, we all know the story, just put the stick, the, you know, and the water will turn out to road and just walk in it. So he passed. And as the story of the, as you watch, subhanAllah, that's the beauty of the Quran. As you watch it, I don't care how many movies they make about it, but when you read the Quran, as if you live it. There's nothing better than the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. So after Musa passed, and he's standing there and he sees Fir'aun. And Fir'aun now standing in the other side. Should I pass? Should I not? Is this magic? Is the water will come back? What's going on? So he's standing in the other side thinking. And what Musa wants to do, he wants to put the stick back so he can bring the water back. So Fir'aun doesn't catch on to them. But Allah told him what? Watrub al-Bahra, Rahwa, leave it. Leave it. So for Musa, in his mind, this is bad. I'm going to leave it. Fir'aun is going to come after me. He's going to destroy me. That's what Musa think. What he perceived that going to be good for him. But what Allah knows, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. They blocked. Brother and sister, they've been plotting against Islam since day one. Since Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you think this is, why is this happening to you? You're naive. Since Muhammad came, before Muhammad came, what they used to say? As-Sadiq al-Amin. Right? That was the description of Muhammad. He's the truthful. He's the one we can trust. And as soon as he came, and he said, Rabbi Allah, as soon as he came, say, worship Allah, this is the right way, and stay away from your own desire, and your own hawa, and your own destruction, then he became what? Number one enemy. And from that time, until today, this is the position of Islam. Islam stands for what's good. And you better believe it. And you better live with it and die on it. Islam stays for what's good. Islam is a religion from Allah Azza wa Jal. Islam is submission to Allah Azza wa Jal. It's not a religion under somebody else's name. It's not under Christ, not under Jewish, some name. All the religion you'll find, it's names after names. And books has changed. New testimony, old testimony, this and this and that. Except Islam. And will remain like that. Because that's what Allah says. Allah revealed the Quran and He will protect to the end of the day. And the enemy of Islam, they know that very well. And they have no other way but just to try to put you in that position. And ask yourself the question. All this enemy, all this media, all this information, we have Muslim leaders, they come and they say, you better monitor the masajid. What else you want? What else you want? Muslim leaders. So it's not just the enemy of Islam, no, among us, exactly the same time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just history repeats itself. Like we used to have munafiqeen there, and there's munafiqeen today. But maybe we can see the munafiqeen today. Maybe we can understand their behavior, and we can see. So rest assured, this is the blood. But you must know for fact, this is your religion, this is the truth. This is what Allah revealed. Good for the animals before the human. Good for the animals before the human. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say what? If you want to sacrifice an animal, don't let the other animal watch. Give me anything from any religion. Say that. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say when you want to slay your animal, make sure the knife is very sharp so you don't harm. Make sure it comes from here so it destroy immediately without any harm, because that's what connects the heart to the brain. The brain to the heart. Right? This is the deen. This is the deen. About the animal. What do you think about the human? But they know now, if this will be practiced, then justice is going to be practiced. Hukuk is going to be there. There's no, handful of rich people they're going to keep sucking from everybody else. There's all these taxes that people try to find a way to run away from it. But the zakah, you'll pay it, and you pay extra for it. See the difference? When somebody come tell you pay zakah, you're going to say, I'm going to pay a little bit more, just to make sure I'm okay with Allah. But now come and pay zakah, taxes, man, I need to find a good account to find out how I can reduce these taxes. And when the zakah was paid, nobody was asking for money. There was money, extra money, to bait in that, the house of the Muslim, treasure. That was money for the people who wants it, Muslim or non-Muslim. This is Islam, very simple, very basic. So you better believe that. And that's the struggle is gonna keep happening until the end of time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is always a group of people, they're gonna stick tied to that deen until they die. And we ask Allah to be among them. In the end, Musa think that if he's going to leave this, then he's going to be destroyed. So Allah said, told him, leave the sea like this. So Fir'aun started to think, he said, this is still sea as is, let me jump after Musa. And indeed, he went after him. And Musa was watching him what? Drowning. So what Musa thought is bad, it became good. Because now you got rid of Fir'aun for good. Did. Drowning. I finish with this. عشان تعرف رحمة ربك. I finish with this so you can know how merciful Allah is عز وجل. So no matter how far are you from Allah, always the door is open for you to go back to Him. Always the door is open. I don't care what you've done. We don't care what you've done. That's what the deen teaches us. That's what Muhammad says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But be careful before you die, or your soul comes out, or the sun comes out from the other side, because that's it. Bab al-Rahmah, Bab al-Tawbah, Maghfoor. That's it, no more. So they will still all have that. But while Fir'aun drowning, Jibreel is saying, hadith, that he comes. You hear in the Quran that Fir'aun say what? Al-an wa? Today I believe. Now I believe. Now while you're drowning, you're seeing this, now you believe there's, you know, and even though with the arrogant, he said, now I believe of the God of Musa. Not just God, no, the God of Musa. Right? So Jibreel, he told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you would have seen me, while I'm going down in the bottom of the Nile, and I'm sucking, I'm taking all the dust in the bottom of it and trying to put it in the mouth of Fir'aun. خَشْيَتْ أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدُهُ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ was worried that Allah, because he might say La ilaha illallah now, right? He's technically saying it while he's dying, right? And that's Fir'aun. He said, I was so worried, Jibreel, the one who knows about Allah Azza wa Jal. He said, I was so worried that Allah will forgive him. SubhanAllah. That's Fir'aun. I don't think you've done anything near to what Fir'aun done. So to be worried, right? But why Jibreel was so, want to get rid of Fir'aun? Because this Fir'aun comes and say, hey, I am your God. And whatever he done to the mu'mineen, you know, with Musa at the time. This is our Islam. We need to live with the mentality of we put our trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. We need to live, and I advise myself before you. Usually I don't talk about something unless it's the most needed for me first before anybody else. I'm very selective what I talk about because I'm in more need than you. In our life stuff, we face situation every day and night, with our family, with our business, and then usually, you know, الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر. That's what Allah says, عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. الشيطان will promise you always to be poor and to be worried and everything else. So we don't want that. Yeah? We want always, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. By remembering Allah, the heart will be tranquil. That's it. So us as a Muslim, we must live on that. We must depend on Allah Azza wa Jal. Take the means, do what you have to do. Want to get the apple, you're going to climb the tree, but put your trust in Allah first. If Allah didn't mean for you to take this apple, you're not going to take it. But in order for you to take it, you must climb the tree. But first, you put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jalla. This is us as a Muslim. Us as a Muslim, we must put our trust in Allah. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت واعف واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت انك سبحانك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك اللهم يا واصل المقطعين سنا اليك اللهم يا واصل المقطعين سنا اليك اللهم انا نسالك من خير ما سالك به عبدك ونبيك محمد ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك به عبدك ونبيك محمد اللهم انا نسالك الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الارض ومغاربها واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين واقم الصلاه